This boy is a case of mandibular prognathism. You can see the occlusion, class 3 with the prognathic mandible. My plan is to do a mandibular setback by doing a bilateral sagittal split osteotomy. You can see me exposing the mandible, the litromolar region and the ramus and the lingular region. And you can see me making the surcus incision, and just like how we make an incision for to remove the impacted wisdom tooth, the entire lingula you can see is exposed, and the lingual nerve and the inferior alveolar nerve is protected. The bone incision line is marked. I use burr and as well as the saw. I am quite comfortable with both, and sometimes I use the saw. You can see me using a saw to make the vertical cut on the body of the mandible. And the only thing is, you should be very careful about the position of the nerve and the feel. That comes only by experience, where when you make the cut on the cortex as well as when you go inside. And you can see me making the bone cut using a saw. And I know where in the X-ray or in the 3D CT you can see where how much is the depth, where exactly the inferior alveolar nerve is there. Once you make the bone cut, then you can use a chisel or osteotome to split the mandible. After that, once you obtain a mild split, then you can use the spreader. You can see me using the spreader to split the mandible. Now the mandible is split. You can see the inferior alveolar nerve nicely. The inferior alveolar nerve is with the distal fragment, and the proximal fragment is on the. You can see that I'm moving the proximal fragment. You can see nicely the inferior alveolar nerve. Now it's not damaged, and it is with the. This is how a good split is. You can see nicely the entire nerve. So whatever amount you mobilize, there will not be any injury to the nerve at all. How nicely the nerve. So you can see that's the nerve, the neurovascular bund, the vein, nerve and the artery, and they are not damaged. So there is absolutely no bleeding. I do repeat the same procedure on the other opposite side. You can see there also the good split. Now remove the excess bone, whatever the measurement says. On either side, the bone should be removed, and you need to check the condylar position of the and once you check the condylar position, then use a mini plate, a titanium plate, to fix the mandible. Here also you can see me removing the excess bone, and once the mandible is you can see the occlusion. Post-operative occlusion. I don't do intermaxillary wiring if the occlusion comes perfectly well. You can see the plates which are fixed on either side. So this procedure is used for advancement also.